Hello students, today we are going to study communication. What are the objectives of communication? What is the process of communication? And what are the different mediums of communication? So let's start. Communication is the vital element of any organization. It helps in shaping the behavior and the organizational effectiveness. Manager used to spend 75% of their time in communicating with their subordinates and superior. Here we will discuss two definitions, Chester Bernard and Keith Davis. Chester Bernard highlighted that communication is a force in shaping the organization behavior, whereas Keith Davis said that communication is the process of passing and understanding the information from one person to another person. Next, we will study the objectives of communication. There are different objectives of communication. It varies from one organization to another organization and one situation to another situation. So the main objectives of communication is to keep update the employees, subordinate and the peer group, to develop creativity and innovativeness, to help in developing the participative leadership model. It also helps in completing the changes or bringing up the new changes in the organization. It helps in removing the misinformation and rumors. It helps in knowledge management. It also helps in motivating the employees by displaying the attitude of commitment. It also helps in developing team spirit, group task resolution, and psychological bent of mind. It also helps in maintaining and understanding the cordial relationship with the management. So let's start with the process of communication. In communication process, there are two parties. One is the sender and one is the receiver. The sender is known as source. Source used to think what message he or she want to send. Then she or he encrypt the message and then choose the medium in which form he or she want to communicate. Like, it can be in the written form, it can be in the verbal form, or it can be in the form of physical gestures or sign. So after selecting the medium, the sender sends the message. While sending the message, there is an element of disturbance called noise, like network problem. After that, receiver receives the message and gives the feedback. Feedback is very important as it helps in knowing the sender that the message is communicated in the right form, at the right time or not. So this is the process of communication. Now, the means of communication. There are three important means of communication. First, written form. Second, oral form, and third is the non-verbal form. Written form of is used when you want to keep the information forever, means permanent information like policy, standing orders, memos, formal letters, official letters, etc. Written form of message can provide evidence at every time. It works as proof, whereas verbal and written form or oral form of message is the transforming of the views and conveying it through the orally. But this information is not of the permanent nature. There is no records of such information, but it helps in the promotion of better relationships. It is short and effective, but again, the disadvantages are again more, like filtration, distortion, lack of records, misinterpretation. Next, third form is non-verbal form, like gestures, facial expression, handshake, shrugging of the shoulders, palm, forehead, etc., wink of eyes. These are the form of non-verbal form of messages. Body language is also known as kinesis, whereas I had written one more term on the screen. You can check grapevine. Grapevine is an informal way of transmitting information to the maximum number of employees in a minimum possible time. It is like a wildfire. It is a form of informal communication of the messages, not through the hierarchy but out of the hierarchy, depends upon their relations with each other. So grapevine information spreads very quickly. So when you want to spread any information quickly, you can use grapevine communication. Next, we will study the medium, choice of medium. There are three mediums: written, oral and non-verbal. So which medium you will choose will depend upon certain factors like location of sender and receiver, their ability to understand, to read and to give the feedback, the nature of the message, how urgent you want to convey the information, what is the cost involving in passing and receiving the information. So all these factors will definitely force the sender to choose the medium. Like if you want to send any information quickly, then you will select the oral form of message. But whenever you want to send confidential message or the message with the permanent existence, then you will select the written form. Similarly, if you want to praise anyone, you will handshake that person. You will use thumb to say best of luck. So this is the gestures. This is the non-verbal form of the communication using the gesture. Body language is also known as kinesis, as I told you before. So this is my video on communication. In my next video, I will tell you about the different barriers of communication. While communication, you have to face so many barriers. So you can download the notes in from the description box. Before that, like, share and subscribe my channel. And if you have any query, any question, then you can ping me or you can drop the message. You can do the message in the comment box. Thank you for today.